Hi there, Simon from simonwoods.com. Five Sauvignon-y wines here. Some of them have got other grapes in. At least, I'm pretty sure that three of them have got Semillon, and two of them might even have other things in there besides, but we'll find out as we go along. So I've got three from this producer, Grand Main, in the Côte de Duras, next door to Bergerac, which is next door to Bordeaux. So it's Bordeaux grapes. So this one's 100% Sauvignon. The ones I've got coming up, I've got, other things in there, but I may be wrong, but you'll find a link or somewhere that tells you all about them. But yeah, this just says 2013, 100% Sauvignon, 12.5%, give it a whirl. There's a simple, light, catty, herbal, there's what I call a green smell about it. It's things like nettles, and if you do cut grass and let it go that little bit mushy, you get that type of character. Maybe a little bit of flower water in there, you know, if sometimes if you get petals that drop to the bottom of a vase of flowers, there's that, and it goes ever so slightly nicely pongy. If it goes a little bit too far, it goes a bit tinned pea, but smells good and fresh, and yes, it's going to have a bracing side. Yep, bracing citrus, greenness, green gauge. Yeah, it's like a squeeze of lemon in your mouth. And there is some quite a bit of fleshiness there. I don't know whether that's from... it says Sauvignon in there. I don't know whether there's a bit of something else to fatten it up or whether it's lees aging. No, it doesn't say anything on the back to... but yeah, feels like there's a little bit of honeyed character in there. Maybe it's that... I don't know whether they'll have their 2014 out now, but it does all look pretty good as it is. Okay, wine number two. We are in New Zealand, and again, 100% Sauvignon. Craggy Range, single vineyard Sauvignon from Martinborough. Te Muna Road Vineyard. Let's give this a whirl. Some quite similar aromas and to the previous one. There's this green gauge, the citrus in there, and a little bit of the floral character. But this maybe has got a little bit more fleshy fruit in there, gooseberries, things like that. Doesn't feel like it's on that green pepper side. And we're in Martinborough here rather than Marlborough, so it's probably that little bit warmer. So it doesn't really. It seems like it's going to be a fleshier wine than the New Zealand norm. Bit of smoky elderflower type of character coming through there as well. And what I particularly like about it is it's got this rich confidence. If anything, it reminds me more of Sauvignons from Friuli rather than New World Sauvignons. It's got that, slightly weighty citrus fruit with these floral, smoky elderflower overtones. Yeah, that gooseberry that I could smell, maybe that fades into the background, but... one of those wines that, I wouldn't be surprised if the 2014 is on the market now, but it almost feels like it's got a little bit of, still some opening up to do, whereas quite a few New Zealand Sauvignons from 2013, which was a terrific vintage in Marlborough, will be starting to look a little bit disjointed. I like this. Yeah, really nice texture there. Yum, yum. Right, we are in Western Australia with this one. We're in Margaret. It's in big letters on the front. McHenry Honan, Rocky Road, Semillon, Sauvignon Blanc. So Semillon, the dominant grape. Yeah, I'm not sure of the percentages, but you'll be able to find out from a link somewhere, either on this video or on the website. So let's give this a whirl. Well, I've been swirling this for a while. It's intriguing because it started off with the slightly sappy Sauvignon characters coming through, a bit more of that gooseberry, maybe a touch of green pepper, no, maybe not so much. But then they seemed like this richer edge started to emerge. What I think of the more of the Semillon characters, maybe that slightly creamy notes coming out. And that's one of the reasons that people do the blend. The Sauvignon carries the wine when it's young, and then as it ages a little bit more, then the Semillon says, go out of the way, let me take centre stage. Let's see whether that's true when I taste it. cream, there's a really creamy texture there. Gooseberry, like Gooseberry Fool, with maybe a sliver of lime or a sliver of lemon on top to get that. It's like there's the tail end of the Sauvignon perkiness, and now the bit more of the gravitas of Semillon coming through. It's not, it's only 12.5% alcohol. It's amazing how Semillon can give this impression of richness at low alcohols. I mean, the other side of Australia, in the Hunter Valley, some of the Semillons there, maybe they're not as under 10 degrees as some of them were a few years ago, but often you look at them, it's like 10, 11, 11.5% alcohol. But here, I don't think it's going to last as long as Good Hunter Semillon, but as it is at the moment, still, it's got a lot to say for itself, and it's still, yeah, it's fighting fit. I like that. Okay, so wine number four. Wines four and five are both from the domain that we started with, Domaine du Grand Maine, and there is their Cuvée des Vendangeurs, which I think is their top-end white. So I've got two vintages of this, and the first one is 2012, so let's give this one a whirl. It's strange, having come, I don't know whether the Semillon or Sauvignon is the dominant grape here, there is much more of a honeyed floral feel to this than to the McHenry Honan. And there's a bit of the, what I call the Bordeaux tinned pear edge. I get this smoky tinned pear. I was getting a little bit of smokiness in, was it the Craggy Range earlier? But it feels like it's going to have this framework of light smokiness from the oak and juicy fruit as well. Yes, that rich smokiness keeps going through. And fruit-wise, citrus, this tinned pear character, and a really nice texture as well. You almost feel, in the way that pears, you get that slight grittiness in the bit around the pear skin. I get that character coming through here. It's a tasty wine. Let's see whether the 2010 is as good. Let's give that one a whirl. Well, it's got that quite distinctive catty edge, that feline that Sauvignon gets as it gets a little bit older. There is fruit behind it, and it's citrus and gooseberries. Seems to be going on about those a lot in this video. But it's very distinctive smell. Maybe too distinctive for some. Let's have a taste. I'd say good rather than great. I'm not sure how 2010 was as a vintage in this part of the world for white wines. What I remember is I did the a similar pair of the reds a few videos ago, and I had the 2010 and the 2011, and I don't know whether there was a change of winemaking regime from one vintage to the next. The 2012 of the white here, it feels like a more a crisper, slightly more grown up wine. The 2010 is good, but it doesn't feel like it's got the staying power that the 2012 will have. And I think in another 2 years, the 2012 will be looking better than the 2010 is doing today. Does that make sense? Put it this way, I like the 2012, but I think they've done a better job than there with the 2010. Although both are good. Actually, all of them were good. I like them all. Favourite? I'd say a toss-up between the Craggy and the McHenry Honan. They're pretty good. But the Vendangeur 2012 wasn't all that far behind. See you soon.